Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Excuse me. We just have finished Act 1. Believe it or not, after 15 episodes. Would you like to save your investigation up to this point? Yes. Save everything happened. Save 3. That's a new one. I haven't been using them, but just in case. Now continuing the investigation. Act 2. Cure. And no, not Robert Smith. There's a Konami building.
Okay,
knocking
let's try
on his
to
door.
Sort all this out. Metal Gear, would you mind helping out?
Not at all. Now projecting recorded video images.
Gibson calls in and you two immediately head for the abandoned factory in the M District. But when you arrived, Gibson had already been killed by someone or something at the factory. From hair and skin samples recovered from his body, you determined that the perpetrators were two snatchers, one male and one female.
Yep.
In addition, from a floppy disk containing notes from Gibson's investigation, you discovered that snatchers have a crucial defect. Gibson was apparently killed because he had learned about this weak point. And this weak point is a key difference between them and real humans. Their artificial skin cannot tolerate ultraviolet rays. Long-term exposure causes it to become cancerous, a form of melanoma. This severely limits the places and times that they can operate to midwinter, when daylight hours are their shortest, and of course at night. And it looks as if it will take at least 6 months for them to develop a new skin which overcomes this fault. So their biggest weak point was that they had to keep themselves protected from ultraviolet rays over the past 6 months. Gibson really put his earlier training as a science cop to good use in figuring this one out. And that's why they use plenty of sunscreen, even in the middle of the winter.
Winter is coming.
As a result of this, it becomes clear that there is one thing they must have to continue their survival. And that is medical facilities, where they can treat artificial skin which has become cancerous.
That's our next move.
And it appears that Gibson may have located a hospital used for this very purpose. In an effort to determine where Gibson had been investigating, you analyzed his stomach contents, found buffalo meat, and headed to the only place in the city that serves it, Outer Heaven. Isabella Velvet, a dancer at this place, gives you a description, which allows you to put together a montage of the man Gibson was trying to track down. You then ran this montage through the city's data bank, using Jordan. And that gave you two suspects, Ivan Rodriguez and Freddie Nielsen.
Wasn't Ivan.
But from the condition of Ivan's skin, you determined that there was no possibility he could be a snatcher. There was no evidence at all of melanoma. But as he was in possession of Liquid Sky, you turned him over to narcotics. Following that, a search of Freddie Nielsen's home turned up large quantities of sunscreen. Nielsen's wife, Lisa Nielsen, turns out to be a snatcher, and you dispose of her. And you confirm that the skin cells found under Gibson's nails were from Lisa. Freddie Nielsen also turns out to be a snatcher, and you dispose of him as well.
The
hair sample that was found in Gibson's hand is confirmed as being from Freddie. So you are able to determine that these two snatchers, Freddie and Lisa, were the ones who killed Gibson.
Good recap. Very handy. And random.
But then we have a problem. The bounty hunter who saved you, Seed, Random Hajil. An investigation uncovers that the information he provided when he filled out his bounty hunter registration was completely false. So,
what?
Who is this guy? Friend or foe?
He checked
what
out.
What about the bank account he was having his bounty deposited into?
It was a common account used for paying bounty, and the funds were retransferred from there. We couldn't learn anything from it.
Get out of here. Of course
you
can.
Metal. And now for the real fun. The hospital that Gibson had tracked down. If we can hit that, we may be able to shut down this snatch operation of theirs. Or if we can find some kind of patient records there, we may be able to find them quite easily.
So, Little John's memory might provide us with an important lead.
Right.
That's right. If we're lucky, there may be something left that we can work with.
Harry has that.
Navigators record everything their junkers do, just in case.
Just in case, huh? Well, this looks like one of those cases.
Mm-hmm. Harry should have recovered it by now. Go see how he's doing.
We gave it to him.
Seed, I'm counting on you to find this hospital.
It's all up to me. Right. So don't they check up on these bounty hunters? I was thinking that the whole time. I just didn't want to interrupt. So he checks out, right? Randoms, number, and all this stuff. Checks out. He gave me a correct number. But when he registered as a bounty hunter, he gave false information. Don't they check on these people? Don't they run some kind of check? Say, hey, that's not an actual name. Wouldn't you have to show, like, some kind of... Well, down in this day, maybe not a birth certificate, but some kind of birth record, right? I don't know. It doesn't make sense, but hey, that's the story has to move along, so... When he's staring at him back to work. Yep, that's a good old chief over there. So if he has anything new to say about this, the first thing you should do is get Harry to recover Little John's memory for you. Oh, I thought it was going to go over the general, you know, the steps. Step one, two. Little John's memory should offer some clues. Go see Harry. All right, let's go ask about Random. Of course, we don't know anything about him, do we? He's a very shady character, but it doesn't seem to be working against us. Still haven't figured out what this chess piece is supposed to mean, have we? Apparently it had nothing to do with that incident with Freddy. Wait a minute. Harry may know something about that. I already have asked Harry, but maybe Harry will know something more this time. Alright, let's get out of here. All of our evidence except for the chess piece are gone, so... Let's go to the front and talk to Mika. I was curious why the music stopped. Didn't do that before. We're at the reception area. Gillian, pull yourself together. The fate of the city depends on you. You look depressed. Is your investigation not going well? Oh, I'm good. You want to search me? Is this work or play? Sorry about that, Gillian says. I said some things I shouldn't have. I'm shocked that you suspect your friends, Gillian. That's really sad. I'm sorry, Mika. Forgive me, please. I'm gonna do it again. Alright. Your feelings? I'm gonna choose that, but first let me ask if she knows anything about Random. A bounty hunter, eh? Can you trust people like that? Well, he sounds sort of cool, but a little scary, too. I wonder what kind of a person he is. Can you trust people like that? He sounds really fake, like someone out of a novel, you know? Still thinks it's a present for her. Okay, let's talk about our feelings. I've always wondered about this, but how did someone like you end up as a junker? That's a tough question. I'm sure it's for the same reasons as you and Harry. This is our feelings. isn't our feelings. So, Mika, what did you think of the guys who have lost their memories? Sort of mysterious and romantic, but I'm sure it's really hard to live without any memories. No reason to go to the computer room or the detective's room or the shooting range. We'll just go right to engineering and talk to Harry.
About time you got here, Gillian. I've got Little John's memory all ready for you.
Good.
Well, were you able to get anything from it?
Just relax. I'll put it on the monitor for you now.
Just asking.
I'm afraid it was almost completely destroyed beyond recovery. Those snatchers, they sure do a thorough job.
What do you mean? Wasn't there anything left?
Like I said, just relax. I was able to get one video image out of it. I don't have the slightest what this is.
I'm relaxed.
But it's definitely got something to do with Jean's investigation. This is it.
Hospital Olean.
So, Gillian, do you have any idea what this is?
Hospital Olean? This is almost certainly the Snatcher-controlled hospital that Gibson was looking for.
You ought to run the name through Jordan, but if that hospital is not legit, the data won't mean anything. This city is packed with unregistered hospitals.
Hmm. The sign in this picture looks curved. This word Olean might continue past the edge of the image.
Yeah.
I've stored this image. You can view it at any time. Just use the graphic memory command in the possessions menu.
Okay. Do you mind not staring at me like that? You look like you suspect me of something. What's the problem? You got something to say? Say it. You get your kicks doing body searches on senior citizens, do you? You're still young. You should be spending your time with young women, you know. Yeah, well. Mika rejected me. What can I say? Ask him about Random. I've heard he's really good. I already put down at least three of them, but I still don't get along with those types. But I thought that these blasters were the only things that could take out a snatcher. In theory, that's right. A standard ray gun just isn't strong enough. Still, if you modified a standard ray gun to focus its energy much better than usual, you never know. But that would make it much harder to hit your target, right? That's right. In other words, this Random is one heck of a shot. Normally, that just doesn't work. Olean. There's definitely no mistake about Little John's memory. This hospital exists. You can bet your life on that. Okay, so we can look at this picture anytime. That's the visual image that was recovered from Little John's memory. So if we investigate it... Oh wait, I have to go into possessions and then investigate. It appears to read Olean Hospital. That's no doubt the neon sign to some hospital. If we try again. Right. I can talk about my feelings to Harry. Okay. Harry, I'm afraid I just can't fill Gibson's shoes. I don't talk to guys who say wimpy things like that. Harry? Alright then. Feeling shut down. We're going to the computer room. Gillian? What? Harry suggested that we check the hospital using the Jordan system, but... The Jordan system doesn't offer a hospital search function. Yes, I'm aware of that. I was wondering how we were gonna do a fax search, but there wasn't anything about hospitals in there. I figured we'd just find it, you know, an option, but I don't know. Really? Why don't we ask Napoleon? Okay. Can we just look anyway? Yeah, because I figured we'd find it under fact file. I'm not going to bother looking. You were not able to be of service. Much disappointed. Let's talk to Napoleon. Short, dead dude. No, he's not dead. Where'd I write down his info? I know I can get it off of Ask Middle Number, but I have it written down. What? You again? What do you want? More information? Well, I don't want your body, so yeah, I think it's more information. That's right, need your help. Why don't we get the password out of the way first? The 100 day... Oh god, what was it again? Did I write it down? Damn it. 1 a day... At least make it multiple choice. It's like on the tip of my tongue, too. Damn it. Did I write it down here? Wait. I've got all these post-its flying around. I don't need that one. Look me up again after you've done your homework. He hung up. What are we gonna do? Why, we're gonna check Jordan to see the answer. So annoying. I know it's not war. That's what I originally had thought. No! Damn cursor, move when I want you to move. Ah! Pressed it, too. Oh. No wonder I don't do that well on some of these fighting, like, shooting segments. Let me just see. Now it's up there. See how I stayed longer on the A? It lost one. It's behaving itself now. Well, this has to be boring as hell for you guys, so. Thank you. Hate when you get things stuck on your tongue. Rain. 100-day rain. Where is it? 395644. You should dial this number. It's asking me a different one now. The Revolution? Is ended. Okay. Remember that one. If I remember right, we didn't need the period. Huh. Alright, you pass, but we can't talk on the video phone. I'll meet you in the usual place. Oh, jeez. I have to do all this just to meet you somewhere. What are we gonna do? We're gonna meet him in the usual place. Take care out there, Gillian. I will. Can't believe it. Over 20 minutes already? Wow, we can only go to my apartment and Alton Plaza. All these other places are taken out. How limiting. That was my chair you heard creaking. There's very creaky chairs in this, whatever cycle. Turbo cycle? Turbo cycle, yeah. Exit. I wonder if Napoleon is here. Christmas is just around the corner. Winter is coming. What are your plans for Christmas, Gillian? Me? Maybe some time with Jamie? Nah, I don't really know. So you don't have any firm plans yet, do you? Afraid not. Don't worry, I won't let you spend Christmas alone. Thanks. Gillian, if nobody is available, let's spend Christmas together. Christmas with you? It will be my first Christmas. Only in a worst case scenario, you know. Plato's Cavern, I don't know. Christmas with you is the worst case scenario. Aw, that's so mean. A few Christmas trees are set up here and there. There really are a lot of attractive neon signs in the area. The Eat Me sign is still there. Huh? The GR and ALS and that Great Meal sign are burned out. That's funny. There are all kinds of advertisements for holiday products and television programs. It's Christmas everywhere you look. Even Santa Claus is here. He is? Yeah. Crowds of busy year-end shoppers are milling about everywhere. It doesn't appear they're too worried about the Snatcher problem. Oh, that's Santa. A man dressed as Santa Claus is handing out tissues as an advertisement. Huh? That's Santa Claus. Uh-oh. Should I be saving my game? What's wrong? Ugh. Ready for that music to start. Nothing. Probably just my imagination. Shall we check him out? Many such promotional Santa Clauses appear this time of the year. That's true, but that one... If it bothers you that much, why don't we investigate him? Alright, I'm gonna investigate everything else first. You know me. The Christmas sales have got the whole area seething. Nobody seems too worried about the risk of snatchers. Christmas carols in several languages can be heard. Yeah, Christmas is the same in many countries around the world. ...3D projections designed to look like old neon tubes are quite popular now. There really are a lot of different advertisements here. None of those advertisements are useful anymore, are they? The advertising has really become part of the city itself. Everybody appears to be minding their own business. Nothing suspicious at all. Yeah, but there could be a snatcher among them, you know. That's true, but it is too frightening to think about. It is. There are no suspicious types in the area. Alright, we're investigating Santa Claus. Let's check out this Santa. Let's go.
Wait a minute. You're no Santa.
How'd you guess?
What are you doing in that outfit?
Oh, it's Napoleon.
What are you talking about? That's it.
Bless you.
I'm quitting this job. It's too dangerous.
Oh, it's not him.
Somebody's after me.
It's the bouncer.
I'm gonna end up dead, just like Gibson.
Oh, wait. Is this Napoleon or is this the bouncer from the Outer Heaven Club? Oh, it is Napoleon. Alright. He sneezes like the other guy. A Chinese Santa, huh? Somehow you just don't fit the image. Well, I'm so sorry to disappoint you. Give it a rest. This is a disguise, you know? You think I want to be wearing this getup? I don't really want to be wearing this outfit, you know? It's a disguise. It's a traditional Santa Claus costume. He's carrying a large sack over his shoulder. What's in there? Presents? You want some? They're tissues. No thanks. Pass. Got a cold there, Napoleon? Some kind of allergy, I guess. I always get this way in the winter. An allergen that only operates in the winter. That could be Snow 9, you know. One can always pick up traces of Snow 9 wherever snatchers appear. It's just sneezing. It just goes on and on. Hey, don't be touching me. Don't be pulling on the suit. This is a rental, you know. There's a tag on the suit which says Rick Bakery Productions. That's the same place which makes those Outer Heaven masks. That's that place the guy over at Plato's Cavern was telling us all about, right? Yep. No wonder it's so realistic looking. It was made by Rick Bakery Studio. Rick Bakery. Use cash? Oh, we're gonna have to give him more money, aren't we? For the life of me, I can't figure out what this chess piece is supposed to mean. Napoleon says, I wonder what that is. Sounds pretty bad. I don't want to show him the video memory yet. ask about Napoleon, about himself. Why don't you just go ahead and tell us who you really are, Napoleon? Nah, us informers are easier to get along with if you don't know who we really are. One of these days I'll have to tell you why I'm called Napoleon. Look forward to hearing about that. Let's ask about Snow 9 first. It's a man-made strain that was developed by the military years ago as a defensive weapon to help protect bases and the like. But wasn't it all of it disposed of long ago? Yes, but I hear talk that somebody started cultivating it again about 3 years ago. 3 years ago. That's about the same time the Snatchers first appeared. Apparently that stuff grows back quickly even after it's cleaned out. The areas it grows in are off-limits, but the wind brings it right into the city. Okay. That's you. I need some information about underground hospitals. Besides all of the legit hospitals, there are scores of those underground places all over the city. You'll never be able to find them all. Wait a second. You might be able to learn something about those illicit operations by checking up on pharmaceutical orders. After all, almost all the drugs used on the island are manufactured here as well. That's right, Metal Gear says. All of the pharmaceuticals on the island are distributed or manufactured by Kobe Pharmaceuticals. Kobe Pharmaceuticals, huh? That's where Jamie works. Right, very good. Jamie keeps track of records of shipments of pharmaceuticals throughout the island. She might be able to find something out. That's right. Let's call her and ask later on. Good idea. I'm sure a specialist like that will have a lot more to offer you than somebody like me. Alright, let's show him this, video memory. Olean Hospital? Nothing? Oh! Where the heck did I see that? I don't know. About Olean, that's a new option here. Before that, why don't we take care of business? Yeah, I know. I was waiting for that to come up. Damn, take it. Thanks a bundle. It may not be the one you're looking for, but I know an Olean hospital. Another option. The only thing I can think of is that Olean hospital I mentioned. Okay, what about that? Hey, I'm not doing this for fun, you know. Gonna have to do a little better than that. Oh, jeez. Just as greedy as ever, huh? Here, take it. Thank you very much. I don't know too much about it, but it's over in the RF district. For my money, you don't know much about it. Why don't you go check it out?
Alright, I've had it. Don't call me anymore, okay?
Wait a minute, Napoleon. I'll keep any snatchers off your back.
They're after both of us. You better worry about watching your own back. Oh, by the way, here. A little Christmas present for you.
What? Tissues?
See ya. Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho.
No surprise there. He's got plenty of reason to be scared. Besides, I got the information I needed.
There's an advertisement on the back of that pack of tissues.
This is an ad for Outer Heaven. Just how many different jobs does that guy have?
So he is the guy. He is the bouncer. This is a waste of precious time, Gillian. Let's head to this Olean hospital that Napoleon mentioned. Well, I want to see what we have here. Hey, somebody dropped something weird here. That's a cigarette butt. Oh. That's why I choose random stuff like that, guys. Beer. Alright. What'd he give us? He gave us something. Maybe it's the same one that we already got. Or it's just not important. I figured it was the number for it. Hold on a second. Jamie's number 393444. Oh, what?